what bam! I wake up and I think maybe I should go run. So I check the weather and what bam! This beautiful snow covering all of Toronto, and it's still snowing. Oh my gosh, I hope it snows all day long. I hope it snows so much that we have to build tunnels under the walls, under our doors to get through the city. You guys, I just love winter so, so much. So instead of doing an outdoor run, I am basically just going to do some jogging on the spot at home today, and also gonna follow like a workout video from YouTube. I really like Sydney Cummings lately, so I've been doing a few of her workouts. And because it's just so snowy and nice, it's a nice day to cozy up and catch up on some books, some reading, and some in-house errands. I've been out and about all week, and so today is like a good day for me to just like meal prep for the rest of the week, clean my house, dust things off, answer a few emails, back to blogging a little bit. My friend is coming over later on, so I can't wait to have her over. We're gonna catch up because a lot of stuff has happened. My fitties, a lot of stuff. Okay, and I'll show you a little bit of what I do today. So I'm gonna start off by meal prepping my salmon. So I've already defrosted it. I'll show you right now. So I've already defrosted a lot of salmon. As you can see, okay, they're all in plastic bags. And what I like to do, if you're a past subscriber of mine, is I peel apart the skin from the meat. And so I bake the skin in the oven, and then I eat the meat part raw because I love eating raw salmon, and I would do that. So I'm doing that for the rest of the week, and I'm putting them in glass containers like these so that I can portion them out. Living sustainably a little bit. I also have some soup cooking, pork soup with bay leaves. And yeah, so that is what I will be doing today. So I don't know if I've ever mentioned this, but I have been taking this probiotic with prebiotic supplement, about 2 capsules per day, first thing in the morning, and I think that it's actually been helping with my mood and also my sleep. So I originally took this just to see if it was gonna help my digestion as well and also improve my mood, because what happens is a probiotic, when you have a healthy gut, it helps with better sleep because it helps with serotonin boosting, which is your happy hormone. And serotonin turns into melatonin at night, which helps you sleep. So I took this just to see like how it goes. I'm not done yet, but I think my sleep has been really good, because I had some really nice dreams last night. Okay, so there's that. Something else I've been trying is this potassium glycinate liquid. So generally, potassium helps with electrolytes and also energy balance, especially when you're on a keto diet. You tend to be a little bit lower in the potassium, especially if you're going through keto flu. But I just take it because I'm active and, you know, hashtag health. Some other new things I've been trying is this cold brew coffee from Califia Farms. It's made of almond milk, a little bit of coconut cream, and obviously cold brew coffee. That's just like a latte in my mouth. This whole bottle is about 60 calories, I wanna say. So I like the taste of that. And get this, I've never been a juicer. I've never jumped on the celery juice wagon or, you know, eating green smoothies and stuff like that. But I snatched this because this was, they were gonna throw this away over at the health food store. So I thought, oh, I might as well give it a try. It's not too bad. The macros are basically purely carbs, okay, all from sugar. I'm only gonna take a sip. And actually, I like celery juice. The only ingredient in here is celery. So it's not something I'm gonna have consistently every single day, but I thought, here's my chance to try it. I've made myself some hot chocolate using almond milk, a mix of almond milk, cacao, and a little drop of stevia. I'm gonna mix this up and drink that. Hashtag cozy, cozy, cozy. So while I'm doing meal prepping, a lot of times, I also like to play a podcast in the background. So I'm constantly learning about something while I'm multitasking. So these are some of the podcasts that I'm... Can't wait to listen to this one, How to Cultivate Awareness by Tony Robbins, because I love his podcast so much. Okay, I'm subscribed to some business and spirituality ones and self-development. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna do. And I just got a text message. I am finally done. This is what's not fitting on my baking tray right now. My baking tray is currently in the oven at 350 degrees. So you can see here that I have taken the muscle off of the bone of the salmon and have also de-skinned it. And what I do is I bake these two until they're crispy and I eat them. And then the meat part, which is right here. Can we please just take a minute to appreciate how beautifully marbled this guy is, this salmon is. That's when you know you're getting good texture in your mouth. And you can see here this little, I don't know, pile of protein here is like I boiled a part of the salmon and then this floated to the top and it's basically just all protein. So I'm gonna have that. And yeah, so that is the meat of the salmon. I can't wait to dig into that. I have portioned out some of the salmons for my meal prep for the rest of the week as I'm going out and about. Okay, you can see they're in there. These ones have no bones inside, so you just scoop and eat. And then here we have bacon. Do you hear that snack? Crackle and pop. Yeah. Those are all the salmon skins. That's a salmon bone. And I'm gonna peace out because I'm gonna eat. I'm gonna eat now. Can't wait to eat these guys. And yes, I have been keeping up with my mindful eating, blessing my food before I take a bite. Giving appreciation for where it came from, for the fact that I have enough, that I always will be enough, that I have like high vibe foods, good for my digestion, that's going to serve me and nourish me and just eat calmly and just... So I do this by breathing in and out like this. Hold my breath. Exhale. Do that three times. Say, I love my food. And my food loves me. Oh, that already feels good. Okay. Yeah, I'll see you guys in the next clip. Voila! My fish chips. Beautiful and golden, straight from the oven. Oh, I cannot wait. Project Jomo. the joy of missing out. So, I just came back from a run. And I feel just so elated. I feel like the endorphins are pumping. And a part of me is just thinking, well, we could have ran longer and, you know, it was such a perfect day. And another part of me is thinking, well, maybe you should like not, because there's also slush on the ground and slush just stresses you out and you don't want to fall and da 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 da, right? So my mind's just going back and forth between, should I run a little bit more or should I not run a little bit more? And it was just this whole conundrum that's a little bit unnecessary. Just pick one. Pick one, Linda. So, I ran for about 30 minutes and I felt super duper good. I made a promise to myself that if I was gonna go for a jog, unless it was just super bad, I was gonna jog at least for 30 minutes just to get that. I love the feeling of the cold on my skin as much as I hate it first thing in the morning. I love the feeling of the wind in my hair. I love the feeling of fresh air. Guys, I live in the basement and there are people in the house that smoke indoors. Yes, I'm throwing shade to all of you roomies out there. So, just getting the fresh air is just so nice. So I told myself I was gonna run outside, and a lot of times I go through this decision paralysis where eventually when I finally do pick one, I lament not choosing the other opinion, the other option. And then I think about what I'm missing out on, right? The fear of, oh, I could have done that. I could have, should have, would have. I missed out on such a perfect weather. I missed out on this. Is there a last chance to get this? When in reality, there's just so much abundance. There's just more days like this coming where it's not super duper cold and it's not so snowy that I can't run at all. There's just more opportunities like this. It's not gonna be a waste if I don't take advantage now, right? And that also goes for sales too. Guys, I used to be like a impulse buyer. I go through phases, It's not one of my most proudest habits, just like food addiction and binge eating is not. But I've come like such a long way from there. And same with the shopping thing. Like last minute deals, like Black Friday and Cyber Monday no longer really get to me that much, just because I know that, okay, number one, Boxing Day's around the corner, so I'm just gonna get like another good deal. But also, like sales are up and coming all the time, and if I miss out on now, then I mean, I'm not really missing out because I know that there's gonna be another opportunity for me to buy it. So it's just being gracious and having the joy of missing out, indulging in the joy of the decision that you did take. So the joy of me just going outside today, despite the fact that there was slush and maybe I could have slipped, but just the fact that I got the fresh air in my lungs and the coldness on my skin, I'm gonna indulge in that, then think about the things that I'm missing out on, like, oh, I missed out on going to my favorite trail down the park. I missed out on having a longer run. I missed out on yada da da da. I'm not gonna focus on that. And what I focus on expands. So if I focus on the positive things, more positive things expand, and more positive things are gonna come into my life, and I'm gonna have more opportunities where I can run longer, and there's not gonna be slush, right? And this, you can take this into consideration for all of your life, your work opportunities, your workouts, your food, your eating, right? Is this gonna be the last time that I'm ever gonna taste cake? No. So it makes it a lot less appealing. I'm gonna indulge in the fact that I love salad now because I don't know where I'm going with this, but you know what I mean, right? You know what I mean. So JOMO, this year is totally Project JOMO, the joy of missing out, the joy of indulging in whatever happened, whatever I chose to do. Whatever is happening now, whatever is. That's just my message to you. On another note, I am open to having clients for my health coaching and my habit stacking coaching for you. So if you're looking, girls, if you're looking to live a more elevated, positive and high vibrational life, you're not sure where to start, you're not sure, you know, I don't know how to get my life on track, or I just feel stuck in my life right now and I can't get myself out of this emotional rut and my health sucks and I just don't know where to start. Let me be your help, let me be your guide. Let's have a chat and let's just see where you can go, what you want out of life, and how we can get you there together. So if you want that, just send me a email in the description below. I think I'll also put it here. It's thefittyblog@gmail.com. Send me an email and then we can jump on a call. It'll just be like 15 minutes and we can get to know each other. No pressure. Also, I would love if you joined the Fitty community on Patreon. I'll put the link here and you can also find it down below. It's going to say patreon.com/thefitty, okay? And you can join and be a member. I think there's different tiers, there's different levels of membership. And from there, you could get more access to me. I notice you a lot more. You could ask me a few questions. You can get to know me a little. I can get to know you a little more. And you just get more exclusive offers. And I do have a meditation for you regularly for every single month. When you join, you get access to this secret meditation that I hand make for you, and I send it to you through email. You're not gonna find this online, you're not gonna find this on my YouTube or blog or anywhere like that. This is specifically made because you were in the Fitty community. So if you'd like to join that, please just click the link down in the description below. It helps you out, it also helps me out. So I'm gonna leave you with that and I will see you the next time I see you. Okay, so my friend Alex has gotten me a Christmas gift and I cannot wait to give her hers, but I'm just gonna open this one as an unpackaging little vlog. This is why I love Christmas. Oh, it's circular. Oh, what is this? Okay, it's circular and I feel like it has little stud legs at the bottom. I don't know what this is. Is this bath soap? Oh my god, it's so pretty! Do a zoom up. Oh my god, I love it! Oh, and now I wish I had a Christmas tree. I'm gonna put this on my Christmas tree back at home. Thank you, Alex.
You're welcome.